Okay, time to shift gears a little bit and shift our focus towards understanding the language of DAX. And we're going to start with the core syntax. So consider a simple sum function like this. Let's break this down into its component parts, starting from the left. In gray, we have the measure name. And like I mentioned, measures will always be surrounded by brackets when referenced in formulas, so having spaces here is okay. Now the next component immediately following the equal sign is the function name. Now, interesting note here, calculated columns don't require functions, but measures do. So a calculated column could have what's called a naked reference, meaning it points to a column on its own, not an aggregated version of that column. And that's okay because calculated columns evaluate row by row by row, so you could create calculations for things like discount price, like we practiced in the query editor, where you're essentially taking the value from another column, like retail price, and applying some sort of operation against it. On the other hand, you can't do that with measures. If you try to define a measure with a naked column reference, like transactions quantity, Power BI will return an error since it doesn't know how to translate that into a single value. So you need some sort of aggregation there. And then the last two components here are the table name in orange and the column name in blue. And this particular example reflects what's called a fully qualified column since it's preceded by the table name. And like we talked about when we were working with the query editor, table names with spaces have to be surrounded by single quotes. So here's an example of what that would look like with or without a space. One piece of advice, pro tip here, when you're referencing columns, get in the habit of using the fully qualified name, so table followed by column. But for measure references, just use the measure name itself. That's a nice, easy way to differentiate column references from measure references within your DAX formulas. And there are some cases where that may not always make sense, but for the most part, that's a pretty good practice to follow. So moving on, let's talk about some common DAX operators. And most of these are extremely straightforward. You've got your basic arithmetic operators, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and exponents. Those pretty much speak for themselves. You also have your comparison operators, equal to, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, or not equal to. And I've shown some examples here as well. And then where it gets a bit more interesting is with the text and logical operators. And these ones are a little bit different from other formula languages that you may be used to. So one of the consistent ones is using the ampersand as a concatenation tool, where you can combine values to produce a single text string. But some of the newer ones are the double ampersand, which is an AND condition, or the double pipe, which is the OR condition. And on most PCs, you can find that pipe icon by holding Shift and pressing the key right beneath the backspace. And the fourth example here is called IN, which creates a logical OR statement based on an entire list contained within curly brackets. So, little hint, if you're only going to pay attention to a couple pieces from this slide, pay attention to these two, because these are going to come up a few more times with some of the formulas that we'll be writing. So from here, we're going to outline some of the most common function categories, then begin to add some new calculated fields to our AdventureWorks report.